Have you ever wondered what is going on inside a saw? Yes, the very familiar to everyone reddened and dried up saw, which you shamelessly rip off without paying any attention to the magical work that the body performs to save you from further infection. And if you're wondering how cool the healing process is and why this damn thing itches so much, then let's first take a look at the skin. Yes, I have problems with that, so bring another test subject. So here is the skin. Have you ever tried to weigh your skin? How much do you think it weighs? Half a kilo? A kilo? In fact, its average weight is around 3 kilograms and is equal to 2.7 kilograms. So to the excuse, I am not fat, I am big boned, you can also add, and I've got a lot of skin. Now, the skin consists of two layers, the outer one, which is visible and pleasant to you, the epidermis. The epidermis is constantly regenerated. Approximately every month its cells are replaced by new ones, and the inner layer is called the dermis. Inside it has all the nerve endings, sweat glands, and the most interesting, blood vessels. So if suddenly blood has gushed, then you know that the dermis is damaged. And this is exactly the situation that triggers an incredibly awesome wound healing mechanism. The whole process is split into three phases. The first phase is very logically called inflammation. After getting injured, when the blood begins to flow and strive to leave the body does not like that mess, and while the rest of the cells do not understand what happened, the vessels contract, reducing possible blood loss. This happens during the first 10 minutes. Using clever words, this contraction is called vasoconstriction. During this time, the passing platelets figure out what is happening, and now their task is to self-sacrifice and plug the hole. Why don't they make films about platelets? They are real heroes, but even they need help. In order to stick together, they need glue. I mean, a construction glue. Therefore, wandering colorless protein fibrinogen begins to fall out in the form of filaments. It is called fibrin. And fibrin helps platelets create a strong clot, which prevents external infection from getting inside. But what to do with all the crap that has already entered the body? We urgently need defenders who will destroy the intruders. Or, well, eat them. That process is called phagocytosis, and phagocytosis is performed by the cells of the body, which they call leukocytes. Leukocytes are the common name for white cells, whose function is protection. And in this case, they are eating alien particles, and their cellular feast is called phagocytosis. However, they do not just devour harmful particles, but also produce growth factors. And in order for leukocytes to quickly join the main party, the vessels should expand, increasing cellular permeability. The expansion of the vessel walls occurs within 20 minutes and is called vasodilation. And yes, this is the reverse process of vasoconstriction. This is done due to the activity of the neurotransmitter, histamine. And when our dam is strong, the enemies do not break through from the outside, and everything is kind of cleaned up inside. We are proceeding to regeneration. It happens during the next phase, proliferation. When leukocytes start eating harmful particles, it works as a signal to fibroblasts. Guys, it's time to get to work soon. They are activated in about 2 to 3 days. The role of fibroblasts is to produce collagen, the most important material for the growth of connective tissue. In the first week, when there is a lot of collagen, epithelial cells begin to divide, trying to bring together edges of the wound, and the dermis closes. And during this time, the level of histamine goes through the roof. It is a neurotransmitter responsible for the expansion of the walls of blood vessels. And because of this asshole, we feel itchy. It is an allergen, and now it is clear why anti-allergenic drugs are called antihistamines. Not only does histamine cause itching, but also at this moment, nerve cells grow in the damaged area. And new cells are very sensitive to the slightest movement, which our brain perceives as an itch. And when the wound itches, it heals, as your grandmother used to say. And she was right. And you better not strip off the sore until it dries itself. Then begins the phase of maturation. When the wound is closed and not visible to the human eye, it does not mean that everything is over. On the contrary, everything is just beginning for cells. Inside, the recovery process continues. During this time, the collagen begins to rebuild and tissue remodeling occurs. Gradually, the strength of the damaged area increases. But that's not all. In 1 month, the skin reaches up to 70% of its previous durability, and the maximum possible number is 80%. Meanwhile, the maturation phase can last for 2 years. All this, of course, depends on the location and amount of damage, but the skin won't be able to restore its quality fully. That's what kind of incredible emergency occurs in the cells when you just scratch yourself. And you do not even think about the sacrifice of platelets and the awesomeness of white blood cells when you tear off a sore. Did you like this episode? Smash that like and subscribe to the channel. That's it for today, and I'm Bony Wright.